I'm Mayor Chris Hoy, and I'm here today at the Jory Apartments out in Northeast Salem with Kristin Retherford, our Urban and Community Development Department Director. And we're talking about some of the things that this new bond is going to help us with affordable housing.
So we are so excited that the bond passed and that we've got these additional tools for affordable housing. We've undertaken a number of different affordable housing projects ourselves in the last couple of years, and we've partnered on a lot of affordable housing. Jory Trails, where we are right now, the Jory Apartments, Jory Apartments was an affordable housing project that we partnered in through Urban Renewal. We have a number of other projects around the city that have had federal programs funding or CDBG or home funding or Urban Renewal or other kind of tax credit tools, sort of different market tools to help bring either fully affordable projects to the community or, like with this project, which blends affordable units into market rate housing. So what's so exciting about this bond is that there are a couple of different ways we're looking at approaching this. You know, one is a partnership with our library to have combined affordable housing and library sites, a couple of those in the community. And then there's additional funding that could be used for affordable housing. And so I started to speak about this a little bit ago. We can very rarely fund an affordable housing project from just one resource. Most of these projects rely on a number of different kinds of resources, whether it's the federal funding or whether it's state funds or federal funds, tax credits, urban renewal. Affordable housing requires all of those different tools and bringing them together into a package. So this is one more really important tool to our toolbox.
And what's so wonderful about this example is that it like you said, it's for all levels of market. And so people who may be in some of the affordable units, their neighbors don't know because they're just, it looks just like any other unit. And they're right here in this beautiful complex where it has a swimming pool, a community center. It's got walking paths. It's really a beautiful space out here. It's really exciting that folks who just need a little bit of extra help to build afford a place in today's market are able to get it at a place like this.
And mixed projects like this is kind of what we're leaning into more and more, and what is working best, not just for the residents, but also for the funders and for the developers. It makes the projects more viable, and they're better for the residents to have blended projects like this.
We're long past the day when you had just one big dedicated unit, one complex that's affordable housing, and sort of there's stigma that comes with that and all sorts of things. And this is really the way it should be, is where, you know, it's nobody's business if your unit's affordable or not, if it's getting a subsidy. The fact is that you're a good neighbor just like anybody else, and this just allows that to thrive.
Well, and there's a lot of data out there too that shows that these mixed income projects and putting affordable units in a market rate developments helps people move out of poverty more than having everybody in one development. Yeah.
It's so exciting, and this is just one of many of the affordable housing projects we have going on in Salem. They're all over town. I know oftentimes people think, oh, they're just in this part of town or that part of town, but the truth is we have affordable projects going in all over the city, isn't that
true?
We do.
From South Salem to West Salem to East to North, yeah, all over.
That's fantastic, and we're really so grateful to the residents of Salem for passing this thing. It's going to be such an investment in our community, whether it's affordable housing, parks, streets, sidewalks. I mean, there's so many different aspects. Our fire department, it's really exciting. So I really appreciate you taking the time today to talk to me about this affordable housing aspect of the bond.
You're welcome. I'm looking forward to 10 years and
yes,
see these things come alive, right?
Very much so.
Yeah.
And for more information, you can go to our website, cityofsalem.net/2022bond.